गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. द सब्जेक्ट इज बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग फॉर ईसी एंड सी एस ब्रांच. इन लास्ट वीडियो डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ओम्स लॉ, एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ ओम्स लॉ एंड सम प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन ओम्स लॉ. टुडेज क्लास इज एनालिसिस ऑफ सीरीज इलेक्ट्रिक सर्क्यूट. What do you mean by series electric circuits? A series circuit is one which several resistances are connected one of the other. Such connection is also called as end-to-end connection or series connection or cascade connection. A series circuit is one which several resistances are connected one of the other. Such connection is also called as end-to-end connection or cascade connection. This is called as series electric circuit. This is the type of electric circuits. There is a only one path for the flow of electric current. Here only one path for the flow of electric current. Okay, I am taking one example for series electric circuits. Okay, I am taking three resistances are connected in series manner. Okay, you call as R1, R2, R3. Here R1, R2, then R3 are series electric circuit. Here only one path for flow of electric current, that is I. Okay, I cross the voltage source, V is the voltage source. Okay, now this is one series electric circuits. R1, R2, then R3 are three resistances are connected one end to another. Okay, this is chain like. Okay, across there is only one path. Here also I. This is only one path for the flow of electric current throughout the circuit. This is one series electric circuits. Okay, we find here for using in series electric circuit, you can find what is the value of R1 or R2 or R3, or what is the value of total resistance for this circuit. Then or calculate what is the value of I, or calculate what is the value of voltage source. This is your main aim. What is the total equation for series circuit? Series electric circuit. What is the total resistance for series electric circuits? Okay, in this series electric circuit, we are consider three resistors. Then apply Ohm's law. Apply Ohm's law for electric circuits. Okay, for electric circuits, by applying Ohm's law for whole circuit. Okay, that is I is equal to V by R. That is total current, total voltage, then total resistance for series electric circuit. That is IT is equal to VT by RT. Okay, now potential drop across applying Ohm's law for R1, R2 and R3 circuit. Now apply Ohm's law for R1 circuit, R2 circuit and R3. Therefore, some potential will be dropping here, you call as V1. Some voltage will be dropping here, you call as V2. Some voltage will be dropping here across R3 is V3. Now, in series electric circuits, by applying Ohm's law for R1 is I1 is equal to V1 by R1. Okay. Then in R2, I2 is equal to V2 bar R2. In I3 is equal to V3 by R3. Okay. In series electric circuits, always I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3 is equal to I, because there is only one path for flow of electric current in series electric circuits. I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3 is equal to I. It is nothing but total current. Okay, now apply Ohm's law. Properties of series electric circuits. total voltage is equal to sum of individual potential drop across each resistor, that is V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay, this is the total voltage. Total voltage is equal to sum of potential drop of each resistors, that is R1, R2, then R3, that is V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now call as equation number 1. Now you can interchange here. Vt is equal to It into Rt. Okay, call as equation number 2. Therefore V1 is equal to I into I1 into R1, call as equation number 3. Here V2 is equal to I2 into R3, call as equation number 4. R2. V3 is equal to I3 into R3, call as equation number 5. Now put 2, 3, 4 and 5 in first equation. That is Vt. Vt is equal to It into Rt. V1 is equal to I1 into R1. V2 is equal to I2 into R2. V3 is equal to I3 into R3. Okay. Now, but I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3 is equal to I. That is nothing but total current. Okay. Take this is nothing but I into R1, I into R2, I into R3, because the same current will be flowing in series electric circuit, that is It is equal to I. Therefore I you can take common, remaining I1 plus R2 plus R. Therefore IRT as it is. The equation this I will get cancelled. Total resistance for this circuit is RT is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. If three resistances are there, then total resistance for series electric circuit is RT is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 is equal to measured. Okay, this is your 5 per question. Explain analysis of series electric circuit. That is, a series circuit is one which the several resistances are connected one of the other. Such connection is also called as end-to-end connection or cascade connection. There is only one path for flow of electric current. I consider three resistance. If we are four, that is RT is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4. Okay. Applying Ohm's law for whole circuit, that is IT is equal to, we are getting VT. Then apply Ohm's law for either part of the circuit, for R1, R2, then R3, you are getting these equations. Okay. Now applying Ohm properties of series electric circuit, that is Vt is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Then you are putting all these values. Therefore, you are getting R total is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 up to Rn. Okay, if your n number of resistance are connected, therefore R series is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay, measured in Ohm. This is your analysis of series electric circuit. In your exam, they will ask for 5 mark question. Explain analysis of series electric circuit. Now, next concept, characteristics of series electric circuits. Okay, first character. The same current flows through each resistances. The same current flows through the each resistors. Okay, then the same current will be flowing in R1, R2, R3 like this. Okay, then second property. The supply voltage is sum of the individual voltage drop across the resistance, that is Vt is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 to Vn. Then third, the equivalent resistance is equal to the sum of individual resistance. The equivalent resistance is equal to the sum of individual resistances. Fourth one, the equivalent resistance is the largest of all individual resistance. The equivalent resistance is largest of all individual resistors, that is R is equal to greater than R1, R is equal to greater than R2, R is equal to greater than Rn. Okay, these are the some characteristics of series electric circuit. the next concept is analysis of parallel electric circuits. Analysis of parallel electric circuits. The parallel circuit is one in which the several resistances are connected across one another in such a way that the one terminal of each connected to form a junction point, while other remaining ends are also joined to form a another junction point. Okay, if here take three or four resistances are connected in parallel, these are meeting together one point. This is your input point. Another end is connected, meeting another point. It is terminating point or output point. These are called as the types of parallel electric circuit. I am showing one example for parallel electric circuit. Here, three resistances are taking meeting together. This is one node. Okay, three resistances, that is R1. This is R2. This is R3. These are meeting together one node. This is node or junction here, call as A junction, B junction. R1, R2, then R3. Three resistances are connected in parallel. Several resistances are meeting together one point or another point is connected, a terminating point. This is the junction point across the voltage source. V is the voltage source. In series and parallel electric circuits, in parallel circuit the voltage is same. The parallel circuit the voltage is same, but in series circuit the current is same. Okay, in parallel circuit the voltage is same in all resistances, but in series electric circuit the current is same. Okay, now then this current I1 will be dividing in I is dividing as R1, I2, then I3. For example, the 10 ampere current is there. 10 will be dividing in each resistances. 10 will be dividing, the current will be flowing. That is, in parallel circuit, the total current is equal to the sum of individual branch currents. That is, I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. But in case of series electric circuit, that is V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. This is the main difference in between series circuit and parallel circuit. Okay, I am consider three resistances are connected in parallel across a voltage source. V is same for all resistances. Okay, that is V is equal to, then apply Ohm's law for whole circuit, that is IT is equal to VT by RT. Okay, IT is equal to VT by RT. Now IT means total current, total voltage, total resistance for whole circuit. Now apply Ohm's law for R1, R2, then R3 circuit. For R1 circuit, I1 is equal to V1 by R1. For R2, I2 is equal to V2 by R2. For R3 circuit, I3 is equal to V3 by R3. Okay. But V1 is equal to V2, V is equal to V3 is equal to V. Total voltage V1, V2, V3, the potential drop of each resistors is R1, R2 and R3 is equal to the total voltage. Therefore, I1 is equal to V by R1, I2 is equal to V by R2, I3 is equal to V by R3. Okay, this is nothing but V is equal to RT. Call as equation number 2. Call as equation number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, put the values 2, 3, 4 and 5 equations in first equation. Okay, that is I total. Therefore, VT, V by RT is equal to I1 means V by R1, V by R2, V by R3. V is the common in both sides. You can take outside V 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This V, V will get cancelled. 1 by RT is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. If three resistances are connected, the total resistance is in reciprocal of total resistance is equal to the reciprocal of the sum of reciprocal of all three resistances. Therefore, 1 by RP means parallel is there. You can refer as 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay. If three resistances are connected in parallel, the total sum, the reciprocal of total resistance is equal to the sum of the reciprocal of all resistances measured in ohm. This is your analysis of parallel electric circuits. Okay. If three resistances are connected in parallel, R1, R2, then R3, then apply Ohm's law, then you can put the values of IT, I1, I2 and I3 in equations. You are getting, therefore, IT 1 by RP, the total resistance for parallel electric circuit is 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 up to measured in. This is your 5 mark question, analysis of parallel electric circuits. Okay, now next topic is characteristics of parallel electric circuits. Then the same, the voltage or potential drop across all the resistances in parallel always same. The voltage or potential drop across the all resistances in parallel is always same. Then second, the total current gets dividing into the number of path equal to the number of resistance in parallel. The total current is always sum of all individual current, that is IT. IT is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 up to IN. Okay. Then third, the reciprocal of the equivalent resistance of a parallel circuit is equal to the sum of the reciprocal of individual resistances. That is reciprocal of 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, like this. The reciprocal of equivalent resistance of parallel circuit is equal to the sum of reciprocal of individual resistances. Then last, the equivalent resistance is smallest of all resistance, that is R is smaller than R1. R means total resistance is, okay, smaller than R1 up to R. Okay. Okay. This is your analysis of series electric circuits and analysis of parallel electric circuits, some characteristics of series and parallel electric circuit. Okay, thank you.